Have you ever found yourself in a situation where you want to speak French or write something in French, but you somehow blank out or you don't know in which order to put the words? You just don't know how to build a French sentence, basically. If so, this video is for you. And I suspect it's the case for many people because over the years working as a French learning coach with English speaking adults, I've noticed that one of the things that trips you up the most is the French word order, or generally being able to build a sentence in French and knowing in which order to put the words so that it is grammatically correct. And my experience as a coach is that this struggle is not necessarily with good reason. It is true that there are some things which are difficult in regards to the word order in French. But a lot of things in regards to French word order are actually a lot simpler than you think it is. And I think that if you would only know a very few things and remember a couple of tricks, you would feel a lot more confident about your ability to build a French sentence, and you would be therefore a lot more fluent when you need to speak French or write in French. So that's what we are going to see in this video. My name is Angèle Préteau, and on this channel we talk about what it really takes to learn French, become fluent, and live a bigger life as a French speaker. So the first thing that you need to know, which is actually great news, is that the word order of a French sentence is about 80% the same as the word order in an English sentence. And I don't want you to take that for granted, because this particular word order is rather rare among the languages of the world. Let me just explain what I mean by this. So in most sentences, you have three key elements, and these are the subject, the verb, and the object. And in an English sentence, you know they're in this order: subject, verb, object. For example, I speak English right now, okay? So those are the three orders. And what you need to know is that in a language, those three components, they can be in any order, but every language has a fixed order or a main order that they respect like 99% of the time. So most of the languages of the world, about half, actually have an order which is subject, object, and then verb. And only about a third of the languages of the world have subject, verb, object, and that includes English, like I was saying, and also French. So if I say I speak English and I say it in French, je parle anglais, there you have the exact same order. So that's point number one. It's just really important that you remember that the French word order is not completely random in comparison to the English word order. It's actually 80% the same. And those three things are in the exact same order, which are the most important things. If it's so similar, what trips you up? The thing is that the devil is in the details. And once I created a full workshop for my French Fluency Accelerator students about word order, where I go a lot more in depth than in this video, it's 68 minutes long, and I look at every single granular details, and I got so granular about it, I dived so deep in this topic that I ended up editing the Wikipedia article, because I found out that the Wikipedia article about French grammar, which lists all the positions of the word order in French, just was wrong. Originally, it listed 11 positions. If you were to put all the possible words, you would have 16 positions. And it's not even in a sentence, it's in a particular clause. So if you have understood nothing about this particular point, I'd say that's normal. Like I said, I have made a 68 minutes workshop to explain all of that, so I can't really possibly explain it in this video. So in total, you have 16 possible positions. And of course, if you want to always fill those 16 positions, you are going to get lost. Like, unless you're a very advanced French speaker, you are going to get lost. You don't need to fill all 16 positions. You actually, most of the time, only need those three: subject, verb, object. So the key to making it easier for you to build a French sentence which is correct is to just make shorter sentences. And in the continuation of this video, I will give you some more keys to help you to do just that. The first key that I can give you to make shorter sentences is to simply use less clauses. And if you don't know what a clause is, basically we can say that a clause is a group of words which is organized around a verb. So when I said before that a sentence is made with subject, verb, object, actually, that was not exact. What I meant to say was that a clause is meant with subject, verb, object. And in a sentence, you can have as many clauses as you want. But of course, the more clauses you have, the longer the sentence gets. So for example, if I say, in this video, I am happy to tell you about the things that I have found, which have allowed me to therefore become a French coach, which is able to blah, blah, blah. You realize that I can keep adding the things that, which, blah, blah, blah. And you can make a sentence very, very long. But the longer it gets, the more likely it is that you will make mistakes. So first, use less clauses. If you're a beginner, try to use one clause per each sentence. My name is Angel. I am a French coach. I make this video, right? Not, my name is Angel and I am a French coach who makes this video, because that's long and that's complicated. So try to use less clauses. Another thing that is useful to know if you want to build French sentences is that adjectives are generally after the French noun. And there is a very small list of adjectives, always the same. I think it's about 22 adjectives which are before the noun. And you can just learn that list. So that's 22 adjectives that you need to learn, and then you know that they are before the noun. Or an even easier solution is to just avoid using adjectives, because adjectives are just never compulsory. So most of the time you won't need them, and it allows you to make your sentence shorter and easier. So if your adjective is not absolutely compulsory and you're not sure where to put it and you don't have time to check, you can just kick it out. That helps you make the sentence shorter. The same thing is true for adverbs. So the placement of adverbs can be a little bit different in French than in English. And in particular, in English, you can say, I really like pizza, because you can put the adverb in between the subject and the verb, like I really like pizza. In French, you cannot do that, but you can put the adverb in between the verb and the object, which you can't do in English. So in English, you can't say, I like really pizza. That's wrong. You just can't say that. But in French, you have to say, j'aime beaucoup la pizza. So you can either remember that, or you can get rid of the adverb. You can say, I like pizza, j'aime la pizza. And in essence, you have said the same thing. So don't hesitate to kick out a word if it's not really useful and you don't know where to put it. Making a sentence shorter is always the best option that you can have if you're not sure. Another thing that trips you up often when it comes to building sentences in French is the negations. You probably know at this point, if you have been learning French, that we form the negation with ne and pas, and it's like a sandwich, and in between ne and pas, you put the verb. So if I don't like pizza, je n'aime pas la pizza. That's how you say that in French. Often people just kick out the ne because it's just, it's basically disappearing. So French would say j'aime pas la pizza. That's a bit beyond the scope of this video, but I just wanted to throw that in here because I know some people will tell me in the comments. It is true. So often the ne is kicked out. It's kind of like understated, basically. Now, the thing that trips you up the most with the negation is often that if you have an auxiliary verb, what will be in between in the sandwich will not be the full verb with the two parts, but just the auxiliary verb. In between ne and pas, you always have only a conjugated verb. So you have to look exactly at which verb has been conjugated. Conjugated means that it agrees with the subject, right? And that's what goes between ne and pas. Of course, you can also try to just not use ne pas, or make the sentence, or turn the sentence in another way to be able to avoid it, or make the sentence in present if you don't want to use a compound tense. I agree that auxiliary verb can be pretty tricky. The good news about auxiliary verbs, and that's my next point, is that actually in French, I know you didn't expect that coming, but we have a lot less auxiliary verbs than in English. Think of it. In English, you spend a lot of time using don't or will or is as an auxiliary verb. You can say, I am speaking right now, or I am watching a video on YouTube. And this, by the way, is what we call an aspect in English. So the aspect is a particular variation on a tense. Often when you have ing, like I am watching a video, that's an aspect. And these things don't exist in French. So that's one less thing that we have in French. And we don't have these aspects. So if you say I am watching, it's the same as I watch. And that is also something that I find trips my students up a lot, because they really want to translate the idea that they don't just watch, they are now watching. But in French, it's the same. So make it simpler and don't try to translate the aspects, because we just don't have an aspect in French. It's not a grammatical concept. We have lots of things in French that are annoying, but we have no aspects. So I'm not going to pile up more details in this video, because I know that in these videos, you mostly want to have big things that you can remember, not lots of little things that you're going to forget. There are a lot more things that I could have mentioned in this video, such as pronouns, which are typically before the verb. And if you have more than one pronoun, there is a particular order in which you need to put them. You can't just put your pronouns in any order. And that's, like I said, it's very technical. And I have created a complete workshop in the French Fluency Accelerator program, which, by the way, I will link down below if you want to check it out. In that workshop, I get super granular about it. It's 68 minutes long, so I get into every little details, and I even give you exercises that you can do for every single point. But just for this video, I would like you to really remember that often the best solution is to just use less words and make your sentence shorter, because you will avoid most of the problems if you do that. So that's going to be my takeaway for this video, particularly if you are writing in French or if you are practicing in a safe space with someone who is supportive of you. Try using this strategy. See how you can make your sentence shorter, use less words, use less clauses, remove the words that are not useful. Or if your ideas are really complex, you can just cut your sentence which you want to make in several sentences. I explained this particular strategy in a lot more details in this video, so I will leave you with it and I will see you next Monday.